little Jerusalem represent.
On today's Sip Side, I want to show you where to hide, like the kings long ago would also know. Between you and me, the best place is a cave, because no one can see how you behave.
Welcome to Little Jerusalem. My name is Sean Boshoff. You're joining me in the Sorek Valley, the valley where Samson and Delilah lived. I invite you on a journey of cave exploration, which hopefully you will realize lies more within the deepness of your own heart than simply what your eyes will see. Only a short distance apart from the ancient to the modern discovery, I bring you to the exploration of two amazing caves of the Promised Land. First, I bring you to the Sorek Caves, only recently discovered in 1968, with not much known biblical history. We can see the absolute beauty that was hidden, molded, and matured inside these caves due to years of undiscovered darkness, which can be compared perfectly to the life of King David, who had five extraordinary seasons.
Season 1, Bethlehem.
Being the youngest of eight brothers, he was a shepherd boy in the Judean hills until he was 17 years old, where the prophet Samuel came and anointed him as the next king of Israel. Where after he succeeded to kill Goliath and defeat the Philistines. David killed Goliath in this area, and this released David into his next season.
Season 2, Gibeah.
Also known as the Golden Platter. After Samuel's prophecy, I'm sure he would have thought his kingship was nearby. He was invited to stay at King Saul's palace in Gibeah, was married to King Saul's daughter, making him a prince, won all the battles as the king's commander, and everyone loved him and everything was perfect. But God had a different plan for David. King Saul went insane with jealousy because of David's success and tried to kill David.
Season 3, the Caves of Adullam.
Where it says in scripture that David escaped to the caves of Adullam and hid there. These exact caves, how awesome is that? Where David became the leader of 400 misfits hiding in these same caves. David's cave experience, hiding and running from Saul, lasted for 7 years. He was 30 years old when he became king, after Saul died, where David then moved to Hebron for another 7 years.
Season 4, Hebron.
The same root word in Hebrew for Hebron is chaver, which means friend or united. That's where David and his men grew in stature and unity. Then when David was 37 years old,
Season 5, Zion.
David and his men were strong enough to conquer Jerusalem, the last occupied city of the land promised to Abraham. David was 17 when it was prophesied that he would be king. David was 37 when he became king over all of Israel. 7 of those years he spent in the wilderness and caves like these, being molded and tested and matured and taught by God to become, let me quote God, a man after my own heart and the most favored king of Israel. So if you're going through your own cave experience or might experience one still, don't doubt in God's goodness. Just remember, God might still be busy molding and maturing you to become something great, just like the late discovered Sorek Caves. So from the caves of Adullam, thanks for joining us today, and please keep on tuning in and check out www.littlejerusalem.org.